after watching my video on how I edit Justin Rhodes vlogs, I've had several viewers ask what editing software I use to edit the vlogs. I am a Mac user, and like many people from my generation, my first computer experience was playing Oregon Trail on an old Apple computer. Remember the green screen and the 5 1/4 inch floppy disks? Yeah. I haven't always been a Mac user though. The floor in my shop here is like an ice skating rink. There's just a sheet of ice on the ground. Tarps aren't really meant to be used as doors, apparently. We had a lot of weather come in, and it is pretty bitter cold right now, so all this water's frozen. But in the 1990s, my dad built our first family computer, and it was a PC. And then I just kind of stuck with the PC for a long time, not thinking really much about Apple. I made a couple films in high school, but they were on VHS tapes and weren't really edited well. But then in 2011, I made my first film using a digital camera and needed digital editing software. Hey, how'd you get out? Yeah, you wanna come get the food now though, don't you? The film was a little documentary I made about my son, little buddy, being born.
This is his first meeting with Aunt Jessica. She just got here.
Hi.
I have no idea what editing software I used for that. It's something I downloaded for PC. It was a real drag doing that first edit. It was pretty clunky. The PC just... But I loved making the film so much, and I wanted to make more, and if I was gonna make more, I needed a better workflow. By that point, Apple was really popular again, and they really marketed themselves towards the creatives, so I got me a Mac Mini. My $600 Mac Mini I bought came with a free editing software called Imovie. In fact, Imovie still comes standard on any iPhone or iPad, any Apple computer. iMovie became the software I used to really cut my teeth on learning how to edit, and I found the Mac experience was just way more user-friendly and intuitive than what I was trying to do on the PC. If you're a Mac user and you're looking to get started with editing, iMovie is an excellent starting point. It's easy to use, and like I said, it's already on your equipment. And just to show you that iMovie is really good enough for just about any YouTube vlog you'd see, here are some snippets from a film I made using iMovie back in the early days.
We're going to the beach. Now say hi, water.
Is my head on right? Yeah, okay. My ears are cold. I should have had this on when I was outside. After a couple years of using my iPhone for filming and editing in iMovie, I upgraded my gear a bit and I got into more intermediate filmmaking. With that upgrade, I also needed an upgrade in my editing software. I had outgrown iMovie, and that's when I got into this, Final Cut Pro. Final Cut is an Apple software that is a professional version of iMovie. It is definitely professional enough to where if you needed to, you could edit a Hollywood feature film with it. Final Cut Pro costs $300, so in 2013, when I was a hobbyist, that was a big jump for me, but I took the jump and it was totally worth the investment. Final Cut Pro is still the editing software that I prefer. It's what I use every day, and I haven't even come close to outgrowing it. And this software is super easy to use, just like iMovie, so it's like a next level. It works like iMovie, but it has more features. I could get into more details on why I like this software versus some others, but kind of the higher level stuff is it's $300, one-time purchase, you're not paying a monthly fee on it, and it's super fast, which saves a lot of time. So I paid $300 for this 9 years ago, and now I make a full-time living just using this software pretty much, so it's been a good investment. Final Cut Pro is not the only software that I use or have used though. This software right here is Adobe Premiere Pro. Premiere Pro is the software that Justin Rhodes used when he was editing his own vlogs. It's also the software he wanted me to use when I started editing his vlog, because the biggest benefit with Adobe Premiere, in my opinion, is it has a cloud sharing aspect to it. So I can take my edited project and Justin can log in from his side and see the project, and he could make tweaks to it. The functionality of the software is practically the same. You get a professional software with professional results, but the downside here with Adobe Premiere, it is way less user-friendly. The way the software works is just slower. The thing I like least about Premiere Pro is it's a monthly fee to use it. You gotta pay $30. I think it's $30. $30 a month. Again, Final Cut Pro cost me $300. I paid for it 9 years ago and I've never paid another dime for it. Premiere Pro costs $30 a month, so just after 10 months of use, you're gonna hit $300. And then every month after that, $30, right out the window. But Premiere Pro works for either Apple or PC, so if you're a PC user, this might be the way to go. But there is one other professional editing software that I have some familiarity with worth mentioning here, and that's DaVinci Resolve. DaVinci Resolve has two versions, the free version and then the pro version, which costs $300. But the free version is super robust and you can edit just about anything you could possibly imagine in there just on the free version. Where DaVinci Resolve really shines is in the color correction area. Many professional colorists who will do professional color grading and color correction will actually use DaVinci Resolve for those purposes. I do use DaVinci Resolve in a limited capacity, but since I'm super fast in Final Cut Pro, comparatively speaking, I just tend to just go there. My editing software recommendations are as follows. If you're a Mac user and you're just getting into editing, you want to learn something basic, start with iMovie. When you're ready to progress, or if you're already a more intermediate editor, Final Cut Pro if you're a Mac user. If you're a PC user, I would recommend DaVinci Resolve over Premiere Pro. And just like Premiere Pro, DaVinci works on Mac or PC. But if you're on PC, DaVinci Resolve is the way forward. That's my take on the software. I know there are a bunch of other programs out there you could use. Some I've heard of, but really I don't have familiarity with. But your major ones are the ones I talked about. As always, if you have any questions about video production or editing software, just leave a comment down below and I'll get to it.